Aynen, this is my Bilkent University Applied Electromagnetic Course Project Cavity Resonator. As a beginning, I want to show the cavity resonator first, then explain how I made it and show the results. This is the cavity resonator. You can see from outside and inside. There is two antennas, you can see. Yes. Okay. Then, materials. I used cardboard and aluminium foil to build the resonator. I cut cardboard in rectangular shapes, I covered them with aluminium foil and gummed them. I used 75 ohm coaxial cable as antennas to transmit and receive the signals. There are 5 stages of my project, as you can see. Determining the dimensions of the resonator and location of the antenna, building resonator, impedance matching and measurements. I used these frequency equations from the course book. I wanted to excite TE101 mode, therefore M and P are 1 and M is equal to 0 in this case. From the equation, LX is 25 cm and LZ is 20 cm should work. To excite TE101 mode in the resonator, I needed to place the antenna around the maximum point of the electric field. It is obviously, it will be maximum when sine terms are equal to 1, therefore x is equal to 0.125 meter and z is equal to 0.10 meter should work. As impedance matching process, I first measured the impedance of the resonator circuit at resonance frequency. As you can see, impedance before matching is 22.69 minus 14.57 J. I needed to match it with 50 ohm. I used single stop method to match. Location of the short circuited coaxial cable is 10.2 cm away from the load and the length of it is 9.3 cm. As you can see, after matching, impedance is 46.74 minus 1.35 J, which is really close to 50 ohm. Then I measure its log map on network analyzer. You can see the log map. You can see there is 35.6 dB decrease at 970 MHz, which is the resonance frequency. There are also small fluctuations at different frequencies. The reason behind it may be that the inside of the resonator is not so smooth. Then I send a wave inside of the resonator and measure the output with another antenna. As you can see, input has 1.43 volt peak to peak and output has 0.71 volt peak to peak at resonance frequency. The ratio is 1 over 2 at resonance frequency. When I change the frequency of the input, output decreased and the ratio became 1 over 13. The reason behind it: at resonance frequency, waves form standing waves, which is easy to measure. But when frequency changes, waves cannot form standing waves. Their phases are different, therefore their summation is randomly distributed and meaningless.